Thursday's price action took everyone by surprise, with the index closing 154 points up, or 2.5% higher, closing above 6364. Gio Perez of Papa Securities says there seems to be no immediate fundamental reason for this, especially with the National Capital Region remaining in general community quarantine. The index saw what Gio describes as a wedge breakout at the close, and the FIBO targets would point to the 6,500 to 6,600 level. The PSEI starts trading from above 6,364. Well, with us now for more is Chris Mangan, the head of research at AAA Equities. Good to see you again, Chris. Welcome to the program.
Thanks for having me. Good morning.
Right. So how are you gauging the market open?
Yeah, I think the optimism that we're seeing from investors right now is not only because of the performance of markets abroad, but really I think investors are cheering the LTFRB's decision to have jeepneys back on the road today. Now, they just approved, I think, 49 routes of traditional jeepneys to start faring the roads today. And increased mobility has always equaled faster economic activity, and that's what I think investors are looking at right now.
So slowly but surely, mobility helping the economy pick up again, but for how long? And how is that going to be priced into the market going forward?
Well, I think this is stair-stepping back to normalcy. I think we've seen the worst of this COVID-19 pandemic, and now everyone's focus is on how fast the economy can come back to life. Now, the more public transportation we see, that's going to be a big gauge of how quickly we can recover. For the most part, I think it's already priced in. From the market's drop back in March to where it's at now, I think investors have rushed in and have already priced in the recovery. Now, as long as we don't see really disappointing numbers for third quarter, I think the market's on track to keep moving higher.
Yeah, you know, it appears that there's two narratives here. An economy wanting to get back on track, and get back on track it is, albeit slowly, and the infection curve, it's still on the way up. So to what extent do you think investors might be concerned again about the fact that the government hadn't really contained the issue?
Well, in terms of rising infections, I think it's generally because of more testing. We've only been able to catch up in the last month and a half on testing a large number. But what I'm really looking at is the death rate. COVID deaths on a daily basis are really at single digits. We may get the occasional double digits, but I think that's really managed. Our medical facilities are not overwhelmed. To me, it looks like they have it under control. Now, what investors might look at, what might be a risk in the longer term is if we get a spike in those deaths. As long as the deaths keep coming in at this average low rate, I think it warrants the economy coming back and everybody going back to doing what they were doing pre-COVID.
Right. When you take a look at the value and the volumes in the markets, what do you make of the lighter foreign selling on Thursday at 600 million pesos versus the nearly 1 billion that we saw during the latter half of June?
Yeah, well, in terms of foreign flows, they've really been rushing out of our market. We've seen foreign outflows since the beginning of the year, and I think it's up to more than 60 billion right now. Now, aside from the massive inflow that we saw because of that Singaporean fund that came into FGEN, I think we're going to continue to see these outflows. It could be foreign investors looking for better opportunities in markets abroad since they're at all-time highs.
So, seems to me the index won't be able to sustain the uptrend then.
Well, I mean, local buying has really done a good job. I'm surprised that it's at this level right now, despite all the foreign outflows. Now, if that can continue, this market can keep going higher. The foreign outflows don't seem to dampen the sentiment as much as it used to be in the previous years. Local buying has really supported this market well, and if that continues, this market can keep going.
So where do we put the money? Do we buy now or wait for the next consolidation? What are you telling clients?
Well, my advice to clients is to buy the dips. That just eases out all the FOMO issues. We don't want, I'm telling clients not to buy as it's going higher, but to wait for it to dip, because the market will pull back. And when it does, that will be the perfect opportunity for you to get in and take advantage of the lower prices.
And then stay for the long term, or do you have a tactical strategy? I mean, how do you differentiate the kind of risk appetites for your investors?
Well, I mean, we're all different investors. I tend to trade the market, trade the volatility. But for most investors, getting in for the long term right now is just the perfect opportunity. I mean, when you look at several companies, I mean, most companies have not even recovered most of their losses since the beginning of March. So you look at the different sectors that have really outperformed. You have the telcos, you have your consumer staples. And what I've been telling my clients recently is to look at the conglomerates. The conglomerates are really well diversified, and it will be a good gauge of how fast this economy can recover.
All right. Trade the volatility. Keep that in mind. Chris, you have a great weekend. Thank you so much for joining us. You keep well.